it's like.
This is my first IDKE. I'm from Albuquerque, New Mexico. I go by the stage name of Papi Chulo, and I'm enjoying it so far.
Yeah, this is my first IDKE. And it's pretty cool, too. I've done a lot of different events I've never seen before. A lot of people I've never seen before, so.
I'm a man blazer from Baltimore, Maryland. This is my second IDK and it's the bomb.
We need a
him, her, him.
We need a her, him first so mm-hmm. that she can be he, she.
Portraying a woman who is portraying a man. I'm gonna listen to some friends in the community that are gonna help me transform into a drag king.
So what do you have coming up? What kind of, where can people see your show?
Well, let's see. I've got a show tonight at a yoga center called Spiritual Salon that Liz Belil put on. Very excited about that. I just did a house concert in Houston, and I'm going to be doing one in San Antonio. Very interested in this new version of performance that is outside of the club. It's more BYOB. That's more potentially intimate and creating an environment in a different way. That's a little bit less outside of the. It's a little bit more outside of the capitalist system. And then you can see me at the, you know, bastion of capitalism, Flipnautics, on the 21st of April.
And was that you I saw playing last night at the laundromat on 30th and Speedway?
Yes. You see what I'm saying? I think it's important. I mean, the thing is my old band, Meet Joy, we played at laundromats. We played in front of banks. You know, the fourth wall is, you know, busting it down and all of that stuff. I think is imperative because I think the role that music can play in our lives is ever changing, ever evolving, you know, and what live performance can mean in terms of audience participation and all of that. So I really, you did see me at a laundromat on a Friday night, and I was surprised that I had as good of a crowd as I did.
Yeah, it seemed like quite a turnout. The place was hopping.
Yeah, and it was hot in there, wasn't it? It was just sultry, and you know, it was like a very hot crowded club with no smoking but with a lot of humidity.
Yeah, actually, I mean, that sounds ingenious. Go to a club and do your laundry at the same time. It's convenient.
Yeah. And multitasking. Yeah, multitasking is very smart.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much. Yeah. Gretchen Phillips.
Hi, I'm Mocha Jean Herrup, and I'm pleased to bring you The Gay, a weekly segment on ME Television spotlighting Texas music and entertainment of particular interest to the queer community. What's queer? Who's queer? Well, by queer, we can mean gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgender, gay-friendly, straight allied, straight-identifying queer, butch, femme, boy, boy with an I, drag king, drag queen, you name it. We're really open around here. The Gay is about showcasing and promoting artists, acts, and events that have an expansive view of gender and sexuality. This can mean anyone. This can mean you. If there's a queer angle, we cover it. Welcome to The Gay.
I'm here talking with Adrian Sneed of the Tuna Helpers, who have just returned from their Midwest tour. How was that, Adrian? How did the Midwesterners, did they get you? Did they like it?
They liked it. They got us. Yeah, and I think they we got lots of great compliments. They were really glad to see what we do.
And what do you do, Adrian?
I like to incorporate lots of different things. Like we use puppets to sing some of the songs and American Sign Language and theatrics, props. You name it.
Adrian, why puppets?
There are some songs that I don't feel comfortable singing, but I feel like a little puppet should sing. the songs are just, I would feel very vulnerable singing them. I think they're mostly about being scared. Those are the songs that the puppets end up singing. So they're very small, and it just, I think it fits them more.
For some of your songs, your sister Bethany signs the song. Does she do that on the album? Does she record that on the album?
No.
She doesn't.
We tried. It's impossible.
Is your dog a puppet?
Are you a puppet? Are you a puppet? No.
When the Vanguard rocks the house, they rock it all way down.
What's going through your head right now, Joanna? Are you excited?
I really am. I'm not so nervous now. I feel as though, you know, it's no big deal. It's just an information meeting. It's going to be just fine. I'm ready. I'm ready to size up the competition and see what I got to pick up. Do we know what room it's in? I'm not sure if they're going to be focusing on the, like, dance aspects of cheerleading, or if they're going to be focusing on the more exercise, athletic, aerobic aspects. I don't know. I'm not sure how peppy I'm going to have to be. It's been a couple years now. I've been, you know, on this campus, and I haven't quite made it into this building. It's good to see ya. You know, apparently UT has gotten a lot of athletic recognition from these trophy cases. You can tell that.
Yeah. It's good to know that. It's good to know, you know, what I know I'll be rooting on.
I'm trying to quit smoking. I mean, even though I'm not coordinated and I'm not athletic, I'm an incredibly flexible person. Everybody has always noticed I'm an incredibly flexible person.
I think you want to hit 9.
9?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Well, if I remember the flyer, yeah. Is anybody here going for the pom-pom tryouts?
I am.
Oh, okay. Well, it's 9:02, right?
9:02.
Okay,
cool.
Fantastic. Can I put you on camera for a sec?
Me?
Yeah. So have you, like, did you cheerlead in high school?
Yes.
Wow, cool. Do they recruit people for cheerleading? I heard they did.
You can get
a scholarship and stuff?
I have no idea.
Oh. Are you here for that too?
Yeah, I do that. I don't know. Either.
You just never know. Really?
I'm a little intimidated.
Yeah. Why would you be intimidated?
They obviously have a lot of talent. It looks like they've been doing this for a long time. A lot of muscle. They all look a lot better than their sports bras. And they're doing a really good job.
Welcome to my pad.
A lot of people mistake me for Lance Bass. I'm not exactly Lance Bass, but I do channel him and he channels me, and we're in communication a lot. I mean, never verbally or in writing or anything. It's all in here. He's got a slightly deeper voice than me, although I think I do sing alto, but he's the, he's the tenor. He's the bass Bass in the group. So you don't hear his voice isolated a lot, but without him, there'd be no bottom.
Love is the drug I'm thinking of. Oh, can't you see? Love is the drug for me. Definitely gonna do that one at the right time.
It's kind of got that sport dyke thing going, but at the same time, there's a revolutionary aspect to it.
What we're looking for is, we're looking to get all of our film stock donated.
It's a lesbian film, and it's actually called Lesbian Film, all lowercase letters. We're a lesbian collective based in San Francisco, although our film's going to be distributed worldwide.
Who are we going to get to donate a camera for free?
I don't know, but we need a lot of stuff from Walgreens.
First, let's work on the scenario. How many scenes?
There's the dream sequence.
What dream sequence?
It comes after the sex.
I mean, it is a lesbian movie, therefore lots and lots of sex.
Murphy Jean and I were brainstorming in the car also about sort of like
wait,
a revolutionary...
Wait, you were talking about this without me?
Well, I mean, we were in traffic.
We were just workshopping the
idea. I thought this was a collaboration.
Of course it's a collaboration. We're a collective.
I think we're all going to be... Like, the reality is we're all going to be thinking about the movie.
I know, but like, I've been thinking about it, but I didn't talk to you about it.
No, I'm totally out of the loop. Like, you guys... Like, well, what are your concerns?
What I remember... was, you know, they've been sleeping on a futon for years, and they wanted to get a real bed, and that would consummate their love.
No, that's totally still going to be in there, but more as like a flashback. Because it's like we're going kind of beyond, like, the first bed.
Welcome to the world of our twisted fantasies and visions and dreams. These gender-bending kings are ready to leave you wet, to leave you panting, to leave you coming back for more. Yeah, so here is a lineup of boys who will be boys.
Kick ass.
Ready? The song's called Take Me to the Disco.
I'm not you.
this fine trio of amazing babes weren't personal friends of mine, it would be such an honor and such a pleasure to introduce you to Lord Douglas Phillips.
Outside my door. Hello. Is it me you're looking for? I can't see it.